I met Bob about 5 months ago on a dating app. His profile said that he was an attorney, he was a pilot, and he had a small plane. He was standing in front of a beautiful home with a built-in pool, big brick house, and a lot of land. We had our first date. Things moved very quickly. And then I moved into his place. He continued to tell me the lies after I moved in. The one red flag that went up in the very beginning was his age. He told me he was 59. But of course, I Googled him, and it kept coming up as 63 everywhere. Bob wanted to maintain the impression that he was an attorney. Bob would actually put a suit and tie on and walk out the front door in the morning. The night before, he would ask me to pick out his tie for him, which I thought was cute, you know. He had a daily planner with travel. He would talk to me about the cases and what they were settling for. There was a lot of money issues. He was an attorney, so I figured he had some disposable income, and even just to go have a drink or something, sometimes he didn't have the money for that. It was kind of strange, and it sort of worried me. Right after my son died, he asked to borrow $600 or $700. In total, I probably loaned him about $2,000. Because of my cancer, I have pain medication. In 2 weeks' time, he took 70 to 80 pills. I confronted him, and he right away said, "Oh yeah, I meant to tell you, I took them." There were a lot of clues that he was not being honest with me. I texted Sarah, "I just have some questions that I really need answers." I found out he wasn't 59, he wasn't an attorney, he didn't own a plane, the house was foreclosed. I was just blown away. I felt taken advantage of. It was all lies. I ended the relationship and then I eventually moved out.
Sherry, welcome.
Thank you.
You know, in the midst of all that and talking about Bob, just in passing, you said right after your son passed away, which is not too terribly long ago. I'm very sorry for your loss,
Thank
by the
you.
Way.
Thank you very much.
I don't want that to just slide by there. I know that's very, very difficult.
It is.
So I'm sorry you had to deal with that.
Thank you.
He created a whole fantasy world and then pulled you into it, right?
He sure did.
And when this daytimer he's talking about, he said he didn't really keep a daytimer of activities, but he actually did, right? It wasn't just interviews, it was...
No, because I didn't know he was going on interviews. I thought he had a job.
Yeah, so. And there were a list of airports that were in there where he could fly out locally with his airplane, where he could get to another airport to work on a case and things like that.
Right, and that places that he could take me that we wouldn't have to stop and get more fuel, and so that he had made this list of airports that were...
And that's what was in this day planner.
Yes.
So is she lying?
No, I'm sure it was in there. Dr. Phil, the majority of things that were in there, because I used two colors, green and yellow. One was for bills and one was for interviews. That's what I did.
What color were the lies?
White.
Because she's saying that you were saying I'm going to work on this case and that case and these airports I can fly to and stuff like that. And not 4 minutes ago, I asked you that and you said, no, none of that was in there.
They're in there, obviously.
I'm right. Sure, yep. I know. I've already read it. I've been through it. Yep. Sherry, you busted him at the library once, right?
I did.
Went down there, and where was he supposed to be?
I was so angry. He was at work. He was supposed to be at work. And the night before, I said, "Bob, please come clean and tell me if you don't have this job." And he showed me his badge and everything. And then I saw a text from one of the daughters that said they saw his car at the library. And I was so angry, and I just threw on my clothes and walked right in, and there he was spread out in a little glass enclosed room in the library, like it was his office. He was on the phone and he had papers, and I said, "Oh, this is a nice law firm." And he was like, "Oh, you know, let me explain." I said, "I'm done. I don't want to talk to you and I don't want to hear what you have to say." And I left.
You know, people lie for a lot of different reasons. I actually have a list of the main reasons that people lie, and you hit an awful lot of them. You're creating this whole world so you don't have to earn the things that you wish you had and once did. So you just create a fantasy so you can have them anyway.